dinner and a movie. Let's head now this morning to the editorial coordinator and film critic for HollywoodChicago.com. Patrick McDonald is back with us. Hey, Patrick, good morning. Hello.
Good morning. Be safe, be healthy, wear a mask.
It's Russia week here. Wow.
Russia week. If they can steal an election, they can have a week of...
All right.
So these are two films that are both available on video demand this week, and they have Russian themes.
Hmm.
So there you go.
Sputnik?
Yes, Sputnik.
All right.
Sputnik. This is a Russian movie that was part of this year's Tribeca Film Fest. It was going to have its world premiere before the fest went virtual, so it was picked up by IFC Films. A Russian cosmonaut, 1983, has something strange happen to him when he re-enters the Earth's atmosphere, and the Soviet-era scientists can't figure out what's wrong. They bring in a radical female psychotherapist to think outside the box, and she learns that the space traveler has a parasite living inside him, sort of like the film Alien. This creature has needs, including what it eats. The symbolic layers in this film are stunning, especially with the id and the ego fighting within the host and parasite, not to mention the paranoia of good old Soviet Union. This is a psychological science fiction at its best, and a good gross-out horror film as well. Sputnik, 4 out of 5.
Oh, wow, Sputnik, 4 out of 5. Wow, so the parasite growing inside, oh, man.
Exactly.
Red Penguins, tell us about this one.
Scott, what happens when two American entrepreneurs invest in the Russian Red Army hockey team in 1993 and send a slick marketing type to Moscow to make it work? That's the premise of the true story of the Red Penguins, the result of the American-Russian capitalistic merger, the first one, which was basically designed to get the Pittsburgh Penguins NHL club an advantage to Russian players. Pretty smart. The documentary is an amazing portrait of the immediate post-Soviet years, which was marred by chaos and organized crime. The film concludes with a crescendo of voices, including American fear, Russian secrecy, and of course, Vladimir Putin. Or Putin, if you like. Director Gabe Polsky is our cinematic Russian cultural tutor, and he knows which levers to pull that gives the film an almost a beauty in its exposure of human agendas and indecency. It's all about the money, Scott. Red Penguins, 4.5 out of 5.
Wow, even more than the Sputnik, you like that. Okay, boy, that sounds great. And that's a lot of sports guys would be interested in that film, too.
Yeah.